Is it possible for a bike rider to outrun a jet airplane? Actually, yeah.
The World According to Jon.
Hello and welcome to The World According to Jon. My name is, as you know, Jon Paula, and in today's video I'd like to discuss a story from Los Angeles last month where some bike riders decided to race a JetBlue flight. During Carmageddon, that one weekend in Los Angeles in July where they'd closed down the 405 freeway to demo a bridge, lots of people decided to take up alternate modes of transportation. And during this Carmageddon fiasco weekend, JetBlue Airlines decided to offer a novelty $4 flight from Burbank Airport to Long Beach Airport, a very quick 15-minute flight they would never normally have a purpose to serve, but this was just a gimmick. If you want to beat the, quote, traffic of Carmageddon weekend, you pay $4, you can fly from one end of the city to the other. Shortly after JetBlue offered this novelty flight, Los Angeles cyclist Tom Vanderbilt posited on Twitter that a bike could probably beat an airplane given all the security and other times involved. And shortly after that tweet, the snowball got rolling. A local group of bikers known as Wolfpack Hustle decided they were going to take on Tom's challenge, and they would start in Burbank and race the plane all the way to Long Beach. My friend Ezra decided to also buy tickets on that flight, and since he was one of the only people on the flight that were friends with Wolfpack Hustle, he got roped into this too, and he would be the person on the plane racing the bikes on the ground. So they all got started at Ezra's house in North Hollywood at the same time, and with lots of news media around them, they took off for Long Beach at the same time. Unfortunately, Ezra decided it would probably be a good idea to stick to the recommended FAA time of arriving 90 minutes prior to your flight. It was a very short flight, and there was like no security, so Ezra kind of got to the airport like an hour earlier than he needed to. And as Tom originally suggested, that's the kind of time you lose when you travel by plane. So at the end of this whole experiment, the bikers got from Burbank to Long Beach in just an hour and 35 minutes. Other racers that took the Metro got there in an hour and 45 minutes. One person rollerbladed in 2 hours and 40 minutes. Ezra, the car, and then the airplane, and then a taxi. It took him almost 3 hours to get to Long Beach, so he lost by a huge margin. And it just goes to show you that sometimes, if you have a fast bike and, you know, a nice, clean bike path, which many cities do, and not many people actually know about them, you can outrun a commercial jet if it's a flight less than 35 miles in length. But I thought this was a really cool story. It's such a neat novelty, such a neat concept, and the fact that one of my best friends was directly involved with it was so very cool. Obviously, the entire purpose of this experiment was for fun, and not necessarily to show that bikes are faster than airplanes. Obviously, they're not. The Wolfpack Hustle, though experienced, they averaged a top speed of around 25 miles an hour. The jet was traveling around 300 to 400, but that's not the point. The point of this experiment is to kind of show the viability of bikes as transportation in large metro areas. You don't always have to take cars, taxis, or subways. A bike is usually, and often is, the fastest mode of transportation. And as they showed here, definitely in Los Angeles. So hopefully you enjoyed this story. I thought it was a lot of fun. And thank you to my friend Ezra for sharing a lot of the great footage that he took from the plane and from the news vans and stuff like that. We really appreciate it. Go check out Ezra's channel. That is the first link down below. Make sure to subscribe to him. He is a cool dude, and he will make you laugh. Otherwise, please let me know what you think about this story in the comments down below. But for me, for now, those are my thoughts on flight versus bike. My name is John, and I hope to see you right back here in the very near future.